paraphrasing. That's what we're doing today. This is all stuff you might want to write down because it'll help you. I recommend writing it down in your notebook because it's the only thing to help you. As we get into our, actually, not just as we're getting into our local assessment, but as we're doing any type of writing. Yes, please. You should always bring a notebook to class, not just your composition notebook. That should stay here, but you should also bring a notebook to keep notes in. Quickly. Always bring a notebook. You have your composition notebook, which is for journal writing, essays and stuff like that we write in class. You should also bring a notebook that has the four notes. Paraphrasing. Does anybody know what paraphrasing is? Can somebody tell me what paraphrasing is? What does it mean to paraphrase? Okay. You take something really long and you make it smaller. It could be just, not just a sentence, it could be an entire paragraph. Something like that. You take it in, something large and make it smaller. Like a summary. It's very close to a summary. Very similar to a summary. Sometimes it's even shorter than a summary. Four steps of paraphrasing. That's what we're going to start out with. We'll start out with paraphrasing. Four steps of paraphrasing. Now, one of the keys to paraphrasing is to remember that when you paraphrase something, not only are you shortening it, but you're also putting it in your own words. So it's not a quote. You're not quoting when you paraphrase. It's not a direct quote. You're not going to use exact wording that they use. You're going to put something into your own words. But you're going to use the information that is given to you in order to make up these thoughts during your own words. Do we have that for many back? Okay, so step number one. Four steps of paraphrasing. Step number one, read the text. You can't paraphrase if you don't read the text. You can't say what the text is about if you never read it. So the first thing you have to do is you have to read the text. So right now, for an example, we're going to take this parent letter that I sent out to you guys a little while ago. This is going to be our example. I can't tell you what's in this letter if I never read it. If I didn't read it, I can't tell you what's in the letter. So the first thing you need to do is read the text itself. So step number one, read the text. Step number two, remove the text. Now that you've read it, if you want to properly paraphrase, put it down. Take it away. You read the text. Now put it away. Set it off to the side so you're not looking at it. You read the text. Now you've removed the text. Step number three. Repeat the text out loud or in your head. So now what you're going to do, you've read the text. You've taken the text away, and now you're going to repeat the text. So you're going to tell somebody, basically out loud or in your own head, what did the text say? Once again, we're returning to the parent letter that I sent out. It would say things like, my name is Mr. Bittner. I am your student's language arts or world history teacher. This is my first year teaching 7th grade world history. There is a really great website you can go to for all of your homework. If you want to contact me, feel free to email me, but you can also call me. I basically paraphrased the entire letter there. There's a lot more substance to it, and there's probably a couple of things I missed. But there's a number of the information there. So repeat the text. Now finally, write down what you said. What did I say out loud? What did I say in my head? What were the things, when I said what the, when I repeated the text, what was it that I said? Write that down. You write it down. In so doing, you've just paraphrased the text. You paraphrase the text. Which is a much better option than paraphrasing a text and taking notes on paraphrasing a text. It's a much better option than doing some other class's homework in my class. So we're going to practice. We're going to practice taking some steps to paraphrase. Taking some steps to paraphrase. Ready. Here we go. Here's our first article. I want you guys to read the article. If you can't see it very well, you can move up a little bit. Maybe fill in one of the empty desks up front if you can't see it very well or you can come to the door. This is our first article. So read the article really quick. Pay attention to not just the article, but the other things around the article, the pictures that are in the article, the parts in the article. Okay. Next slide. So now we've read the article, we've read the information, we've read the text. Now we need to remove the text. Next up. And I want you to tell me what you read. Explain what you read. Somebody go write down one thing that they read. You go write down one thing you read. When you guys are writing on the SmartBoard, for those of you who had me last year, you know what you want me to learn about me is I'm not very good at spelling. I have to look things up a lot, which is why I write in a minute. So if you spell something, don't be concerned about this. Your spelling is perfect. So just do the best you can. That's why I make it. Some constellations are named after legends. Excellent. There are 88 constellations.
take stars.
Pen on the ground.
I'll have you write our last one. Ursa Minor, which is one of the constellations, otherwise known as what? It's the other name for Ursa Minor. The Little Dipper. It's a more common name. Ursa Minor is also known as the Little Dipper. Okay, so here we have some things that we learned, some things that we came to know from reading that very short article. So there's a number of things to do. What I want you to do now in your notes, underneath your four things for paraphrasing, is you're going to write your own sentence. You're going to need to come up with your own sentence. So you're going to create a new sentence using the information that you just learned from the paragraph. You're going to write your own sentence about constellations. So using the information that's either up here or the stuff that you remember that may not be up here, you're going to write your own sentence about constellations. You're just writing a sentence, not a paragraph, just a sentence. One sentence. Not an entire article, not a paragraph, just one sentence. Anybody want to write their sentence on the board? No? Okay, excellent. There are 88 different constellations named after many different things and people. There are 88 different constellations named after many different things and people. That's great. It's using the things that you learned, the things that you have here. Okay? One more. Lindsay, you haven't done it yet. Oh, you did?
Yeah.
All right, then never mind. Some of you guys have gone up. Anybody who hasn't gone up and wants to write one now? Who's going up for it? No, you want to write it too. Anybody else who hasn't gone up and wants to write one?
No,
but
I
don't want
to talk to you. All
right, let me do that. Quick one. There we got one.
Is that me?
I ain't very.
Isn't she terrible?
She knows how to hold a grudge, though.
Why? Yeah.
Let all this meanness is live streaming out there.
I know. Oh.
That's the other thing. Is it not only does it live stream, but since it records everything, like it, like every time it live streams. If nobody's watching the live stream, nobody sees it. But since it records everything, and I take all those recordings and put every single recording on YouTube, it's like it's there for forever.
forever.
Yeah, but somebody can copy it.
Yeah.
If I can teach you one thing about the internet, it's this. Whatever you put on the internet, no matter when you delete it or when you delete it, it's still there's a file of it somewhere, someplace.
That's why 18
grams
should
be messy.
That's gonna
rip
things out. Oh, now you can see it. Yeah.
Okay. Alright, bye now. Stars are located by their constellations, which is actually true. One of my favorite constellations, it makes me really happy. There's only a certain time of the year that I can see it from my house, is Orion's Belt, the constellation of Orion. And you can see his belt really clearly. If you can see his belt, you can locate the North Star. The same with Ursa Major. I think the North Star is actually at the tip of Ursa Major. It's in part of Ursa Major. But you can find it from Orion's belt. So you can see Orion's belt, you can find the North Star.
I thought it was like a certain time of day that you
can
see it.
Yeah, you can only see it like a certain time of day and a certain time of year because of where the Ursa Major is. Okay. How about no? Okay, next article. Next article. I want you guys to really quickly read this one. It's a really short one. Really quickly read through it. That's the other thing, the reason why I'm not too concerned about spelling is sometimes the smart word, it doesn't exactly get what you write down. So don't worry about it too much.
Is Leo going to just make one
when
she started writing?
Yeah. Yeah. Most famous dog show in the world. Excellent.
Our friends come. They were going to go to the Westminster community.
All right.
I
Okay. Alright. So we're gonna move on. We're gonna take this information that we've learned, or any other information that you know you didn't add on here, and you're gonna create your own sentence. So once again, we're gonna move on, we're gonna create our own sentence. Using the information you have, either up here, or the information that you remember from what you read, write down your own sentence. Create your own sentence and write it on your sheet. In your notes. Write it in your notes. I got you mentally logged in here. Everybody else keep writing. Keep writing while Jackson's writing his sentence. So our first sentence that we have right now was Aaron Wilkinson's dog is more famous than him, which is probably correct. It should be than him, but that's fine. That's the problem with SmartBoard. Uno started winning blue ribbons after. His number one. After his first dog show. Excellent. What? What's the name of the book? If you go to my channel. So this is our next one. We have a couple more to do, so let's move on to the next little article. Go ahead and read through this article. Go ahead and read through this article. What's different to the article? Why is this? When is he reading up? Longer, so more.
100. Emily, go grab the, you're gonna grab the next one. The next one. I might do one of them.
Quiet down.
So you see what they're writing down matches what you were going to say, what you're thinking.
Oh, mine is
the same. No. Male fireflies.
Yeah.
Oh, have two light sections. Okay. Male fireflies have two light sections. Emily's grabbing the next one. I think that maybe up is not gone up. It's not. Come on up. Lauren, go grab one. Two pairs of wings. They have fireflies have two pairs of wings.
They're beetles.
They're beetles. They're beetles. Oh, wait. Brandon, go. Brandon, go. Brandon, go. They have six legs. What do you guys? We're probably in a week. We're two antennae. Or antennas. God. Yes, we go. So it's going to be our last one before we create a new sentence. Last one before we create a new sentence. Okay, awesome. I want you guys to come up with your own sentence. Come up with your own sentence really quickly. Although I do have to point out one thing. Because I have to do this. Sorry, I have to do that. Quickly write your sentences down. Write your sentences down. Andrew, go write your sentences down. Your sentence is good.
I have a really good one.
Yeah,
I got one. Here, can I
write one?
I'm going to
Okay, one more, I'm gonna get one more sentence, and we're gonna move on to the last one. One more sentence.
Rock paper scissors.
Now I can start.
So I'm not gonna do it.
Alright. Quiet down. Ladies and gentlemen. Quiet down. Okay, nails shine brighter. Okay. Alright. So male shine bright. So we have two different sentences up here that we've been able to learn, take away from what we read. Two different small ways of paraphrasing what we read. We have one more article to read. One more set of articles. Now, this one's a little bit longer, and the details in it are a little bit more distinct, so you're going to have to pay attention to it. I will tell you, in my last class, we actually had to go back and read the article a second time because we've got a couple things mixed up, so make sure that you're being careful readers and paying attention to details, okay? So here we go. Here's the next one. This is our last article.
Okay, that's
a wrap. Why not read? Here, read the
You know what to do.
What I want you to do really quickly before we start writing our facts down on the board, I want you to quickly write some things in here, or at least 5 things you need to learn on your paper real quick. Write them on your paper because in just a couple minutes, the period's going to end. If you don't get them all up there, I don't want you to forget what happened while you were at break. So quickly on your paper, write 5 things. 5 things you came up with. Thank you.
When we come back from break, we'll start Andy right away with writing our 5 things on coming up with our sentences.
I don't know how to spell it, so I'm probably lying here.
Pause the word. Pause the card.
Okay, no one's sticking mine yet. How do you feel this strikes a person who would have been well? When that monitor.
When's the monitor coming up? The other part I need to be unlocked. First off, the bomb was done in 1964. It's not even the same back here.
I don't know how to spell it. Is it like clear on your computer? Because I don't know if it's right.
I don't have that on my face. I have done what you're supposed to do when you paraphrase. I read the text and I removed the text. So I don't have the text anymore.
There.
Okay. Alright, so these are our things. So what I want you to do. What I want you to do is I want you to write your next sentence. Create a new sentence. What's your new sentence you're going to create? What is your new sentence you're going to create? Using either these facts or the ones that you wrote down. What is your new sentence you're going to create? What is your new sentence you're going to create? All right. Do we have our sentences? Kill him already. Text when you start doing your actual local assessment, when you start doing your writing, whatever you start doing, any type of research paper where you're using informational text, you should always do this sort of process. Read through it. Pick out three or four things that are important pieces of information. Put them on the side.
paraphrase them really quickly so that you can use it, that paraphrase in your text. If you... Alright, Doug, I'm here for you.
I got excited.
Okay. Alright. Part of the reason why this is important, the main reason why this is important, is because when you're writing an argumentative essay, any type of argumentative essay, whether it's for class or for anything else, whenever you're writing an argumentative essay, it is very, very important that you have arguments in there that are justified and supported. And what I mean by that is, if they're not justified and supported, they don't have a grounding in some type of fact, then they're just opinions. And if you're writing something that's just opinions, you could say anything you wanted. It wouldn't be true, and it wouldn't be good, but you could say anything you wanted. If I didn't have to justify my arguments using facts to back them up, I could write an entire paper about how the Cubs are going to win the World Series this year and every year after that. Is that possible? No. No. It's not possible they could win this year. They're not going to make the playoffs this year. They're terrible. They're not. Is this fair? They are mathematically, they've been mathematically eliminated from the playoffs since probably mid-July. They just don't have a good enough record to do it. Neither do the White Sox. So if any of you White Sox fans in here, you guys don't either. They're both bad. Neither one of them do. So if I could just say, write all my stuff based solely on opinion, but I could say that. I could say they could win the World Series because I'm not basing any of it in fact. You have to base your arguments in fact. You have to. So you can talk about velociraptors and how they're related to the Deinonychus, however, Deinonychus. Deinonychus. You can talk about how they're related, and they both have knife-like claws. Because that is something that is justified, is based in fact, right? And you get those facts from doing your reading, from reading the articles. So you've read the article, you pulled out facts, they're important. And then you've used those facts to justify your sentences, to make them legitimate. When you do your regular argumentative writing, whether it's for the local assessment, whether it's for a paper that we do in class, you're going to need to do the same thing. You're going to need to be able to read an article, pull out information that's important, paraphrase it, and then reuse it in your article to help back up your arguments, to help back up your points, to make them justified and legitimate. Otherwise, it's just your opinion. And I don't really care to read your opinion. I have my own opinions. If I wanted your opinion, I'd give it to you. I don't need to know. I want to read your facts. I want to read the facts. I want to learn something. Okay? So you have to make your arguments justified. Now, I have one last piece of practice that we're going to do. And for this piece of practice, you're going to need the essays that you wrote the other day. So, if you are a tree, please go get your essays from your composition notebook, unless you have it with you right now. If you have it in front of you, that's fine, take it out. Otherwise, otherwise go get it. Why don't you take out your essays? I also want you to take out a separate sheet of paper. A separate sheet of paper, one not in your notebook, one that does not have any notes on the back half of it. It's a completely blank piece of paper that you can turn in to me. And you're going to. No, just that all you need is a note. Have a great one. Yeah, tree. Trees are in the middle. Okay, so you need your essay out. You need your essay out, and you need a blank piece of paper out that you can turn into me. Alright, Doors, please go get your composition notebook. Doors.
I'm a door.
Come on, you're a door.
Doors, please go get your composition notebook. Alright guys, come on. Patrick, grab your composition notebook.
Patrick. I know this.
Alright, Windows. Windows, if you would please get your composition notebook. Make sure you turn to your essay. Alright, this is what I want you guys to do. So everyone should have their essay out and a blank piece of paper. On your blank piece of paper, I want you to make three large boxes that take up the entire piece of paper. On your blank piece of paper, you're going to make three large boxes. These three large boxes are going to take up your entire piece of paper, okay? So imagine this notebook, this piece of notebook paper here is your paper. You make three large boxes that take up the whole sheet of your blank notebook paper. So whatever it is, your blank piece you took out, you're going to make three large boxes. And then you're going to split those three large boxes in half. So you're going to draw a line right down the middle, split those three large boxes in half. Right?
Yeah.
This way, just like this. Half, just like this. I'm sorry. It's just easier to write. Okay. What I want you to do next is I'm going to give you a partner. And when I give you your partner, what you're going to do is you're going to trade essays with that person. You're going to read through their entire essay. Okay? Just like you read through the articles. When you get to body paragraph number one, you're going to do just like we did with those articles in body paragraph number one. So in this top box, you're going to write, things I learned. And in the bottom one, you're going to write a new sentence. So just like we did in the SmartBoard activity, you're going to write a list of things you learned from body paragraph number one. So this is body number one. This is going to be body paragraph number two. Anybody want to guess what this one is? Body paragraph three. And you're going to do the same things in this one. So when you get to this box, same thing with the third box. So when I give you your partner, you're going to switch essays with them. You're going to read through that person's essay. When you finish, when you get to body paragraph number one, you're going to read through body paragraph number one. You're going to pull off things that you learned from body paragraph number one. And then you're going to write a new sentence that paraphrases the entire paragraph. Sentence should paraphrase the entire paragraph. Right? And you're going to do that for each one of the body paragraphs. Do you need to do that for the introductory paragraph?
No.
No. What about the conclusion?
No.
No. And the reason why you don't need to is because you shouldn't be getting a whole lot of like new information in those. They introduce it, they're going to give you a little bit of new information, and the conclusion is really going to just kind of summarize everything. So you shouldn't need any new stuff in either one of those either. But you're going to get new information. The main meat of the story is going to be in your three body paragraphs. Okay? So, this is how I want you guys to switch. I'm going to make it really easy. Right? You ready? Switch. No, you're just switching. Switch. 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 That's fine. This is what you got. All right, you should be reading. Now that you've switched. Once you've switched, you should be reading. Once you switch, you should be reading and copying your background. Quiet, please. Quiet, please. That should be a reading.